Hello and welcome to Joyce Testing. Yeah, well, the fall has really hit Sweden here. I have tried to make this video for a couple of days now here, but it keeps on raining. It's just been raining non-stop for 2 days, so now we have made a small tarp out here so we can be somewhat dry when we make this video. Well, we need to test anyway. Today we're going to test a Castrum number 10 forest, Swedish forest knife. I've been looking very forward to testing this knife for a long time. It's just a beautiful knife and a stable, nice knife. As you can see here, it has a beautiful drop point. It is full tang all the way. It has a nice angle here on the handle, which makes it very comfortable in the hand. It has a 10 centimeter blade, as you can see here, and the whole knife is 22 centimeters long. It's actually quite wide, this blade. It's 3.8 millimeters thick, so it's quite a thick blade, as you shall see later on when I patron it. It's very good. The handle is oak, and it has just been a lovely knife to work with. It is high carbon steel with a hardening of 5860, so very tough blade, very nice blade, and it's just beautiful with a nice big Scandinavian grind, which makes it sharp and just lovely to work with. Well, let's go ahead and see how it does at patroning here. I've taken some different firewood here. I have some hardwood here. Let's just try this on. Let's see how it goes here. As you can see, I said before here, it has a pretty thick blade, so it just plows through these things here. I have a piece of dry pine here. Actually, it's kind of thick for the blade length, but let's see how it does anyway here. As you can see here, it plows through even though it has lots of things inside. And let's just take a piece of birch here while we are on it. And no worries here. It is, well, it's actually one of the best knife at platoning I've tried so far. I can just keep on going here all day. very nice at platoning. Let's see how it is at chopping. It has some weight on it, so I bet that it's good at chopping also, but the blade is not that wide. But let's take a look at it here. I have a piece of birch here. Let's go over here. See here. It's actually quite comfortable laying on under here, isn't it, Malena?
Yeah.
So let's see how it goes here. As you can see here, it takes, oh, it is kind of, it was a little rotten out there. And let's try it here, anyway. See, even though the blade is not that long, it has the weight to make some good chunks here. And it works very well. Okay, like that. No worries there. I also told you that it was quite sharp, and it is. Let's see how it does at some stitching. Yeah, I have an old piece of willow here. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. See, does some nice stitching here. Let's see how it does at some further stitching. Let's see if we can get a nice. See there? Fine fishes. Third stitching for a piece of dry wood here. Let's see if we can make some of the smallest ones. also works fine. Take a look at that. That's just beautiful. It also has, like every good blade should have, a nice 90 degree angle here on the back. And I can show you here the scrapings of this. This is, as I've mentioned before, excellent tinder. I can try to take on a piece of very dry here. If we wanted to use some fat wood like pine here, we would get a nice, some nice scrapings off it, also for tinder. So this is a wonderful knife at batoning, chopping, stitching, everything. I'll just get my piece of bushcraft I did today on this time. So just a sec. Okay, for bushcrafting today I actually made a toy for the kids. This is a, well, I would say you could call it a buzzer. When you take a piece of string here and swing it around, it makes a wonderful buzzing sound. Actually, I think it's from the Aboriginals in Australia that used to make them. This doesn't sound that high as they do, but it's fun, and the kids have enjoyed playing with it. I'll show you how it works here in just a while here. I also wanted to make a fire here today, and like I said, it has been raining for the last couple of days, so it's good that one has one's hiding place here, and some of the things I've collected here. So I'll just take some of my birch here I have collected when I go out in the woods. When I see a birch that is shedding, I always take some of it, because this is very, very, very good tinder. See if it can work. Gonna make a fire on this one. And I have some of my trusted lau. I don't know what it's called in English. And I'll just take my trusted fire steel here and see if we can make a fire here. So yeah, how it goes. Yeah, almost. Oh, there we go. So, my oldest, youngest one comes. I'll just make a fire here. See? Ah, see how beautiful that makes a fire. So, when it has rained a couple of days, be sure to have your fire kit with you, so that you can make a nice fire. You could probably find some birch to use inside some of the dry parts of the woods, but it's easier to have something with you.
Okay, the deal is you take a piece of string, I've taken a paracord here, and you just swing it hard around, and it makes this brilliant buzzing sound. Let's see if we can make it go here. And actually it's said that you can hear this over a wide distance, because it's very low tone. So just a nice little piece of toy here, carved out of a piece of wood. Okay, for concluding, I've been wearing this knife for a couple of days now. It is just a lovely knife. It works fine. It can chop, it can stitch, can do everything you put this knife through, and it's just lovely to have. And this is a beautiful knife. Take a look at it. The price is I guess around 100 euros, I guess, something like that, and it's just well worth the money. I guarantee you this, you won't be sorry with this knife. I just forgot in the start here about the sheet. Nice sheet, fits well. Nothing nothing spectacular about it, but it's just a nice well made leather sheet, and it's just lovely, a lovely color, and it's just well made. Nothing else to say about the sheet. Well, should we take a look at the knives I've tested just quickly here? See, we started with the Felkniven F1. We tested the Enzo Elva, the Mora Bushcraft, the Karoswanda Axe, the M95 Pendleton, the Holterforce 01, another Felkniven A1, the Danish Vangedal, and the Danish Ole Rundlund knife, Viking replicate, another Enzo, the Trapper, very nice, and last time we did the Karoswanda Overlevelses knife here, also very nice, and this time we did the cast one. I guess next time I'll be making a film about the Light My Fire knife. It's a Mora knife with a fire steel inside the handle. I'm gonna try to test it, but I'm not sure I'm gonna be doing this before the winter or after the winter. It may be that I'll take a little break here during the hardest winter up here and come back to you in spring. But let's see if we can make some videos inside for some of the smaller things. So be sure to subscribe and take a look at my test. I'll be coming back with lots more knives. I have, well, 8 other knives I want to test, Scandinavian knives I want to test. So be sure to subscribe and take a look at what I have. Until then, in this beautiful Swedish weather, see you.